Welcome to part 4 of the STA-6000 tutorial series. In this video, we will be calibrating a tool we used in part 3 to demonstrate verifying torque. If you haven't seen part 3 yet, I recommend watching it before this video. First, we will start by taking our Atlas Copco programming cable and connecting it to the USB serial adapter. Next, we connect the opposite end to the RS-232 number 2 port that is above the Ethernet port, and close up the controller. Then, using the STA-6000 USB cable, we connect the adapter directly to our analyzer. We now attach our rotary transducer to our analyzer, and then mount the transducer to our tool. Back in Tools Talk Power Focus, we now must check that our batch count is at least 3 in the PSET that we created in Part 3. Here we will demonstrate what happens when you don't have a batch count of 3 or more set. We enter the calibration menu, select Power Focus, and then Serial since we are connecting through our adapter. Next, we see our tolerance of plus or minus 5%, and we attempt to start the calibration. Once the analyzer establishes communication, we get a message telling us the batch size is wrong. To remedy this, we must change our batch count in ToolsTalk PF, or directly on the controller if you have a graph model. The calibration needs a minimum of 3 results to be able to calculate a proper calibration value. We change ours to 3 for a quick calibration, and then click Store to save our PSET. We switch right back over to our analyzer and click Start again, but this time we are successful in loading our PSET and starting the calibration. The top value now displays the results from our transducer, while the lower value displays the results directly from our PowerFocus controller. We will now start our rundowns. After our first rundown, we see that the controller is displaying a value of 0.9 Nm, while our transducer measured 0.914. The batch count shows we have performed 1 readings out of 3. Our second batch values now display as we complete our second rundown. After our third and final rundown, we are prompted that our batch is complete. As you can see, our controller and transducer values are very close together, well within our 5% tolerance. This tool doesn't need the calibration value changed, but we'll do it anyway. By hitting the top left button, we now see our old calibration value and what the analyzer suggests we update it to. Our old value was 6.0, but our new suggested value is 6.115. By clicking Store, we will now update our calibration value, which is saved directly to the tool. Now, no matter what controller we use, this tool will remember its calibration value. Let's run the calibration one more time. Again, we hit Start to repeat the process. The analyzer will automatically use the same PSET as before. If you wish to change the PSET, you must select it before starting a new test. We will now perform another 3 rundowns. Right away, you can see our readings are even closer to each other than before. After the batch is complete, we can now see what the analyzer recommends for our new calibration value. They are so close that they don't need to update it, but we do anyway. Back at the main menu on the analyzer, we can go into the Reports menu, then Calibration, to see the two calibrations we just performed. We can print these directly from the analyzer if it's connected to a network, delete the test, or open the report to view it. Here we see our old and new calibration values, and it says that we have updated the value. If we hit cancel after our calibration, the value would not have updated, but the report would still save. Under the Max tab, we could see the difference was only 2.08%. Well within our 5% limit, meaning the tool has passed. If you'd like to save and print your results from a computer, you can connect to a PC running ToolsTalk BLM via USB. Once connected, open up the Reports tab. Then click Calibrations, and then click Power Focus Calibration Report. On the left, we have both reports listed. All of the data shown on the analyzer is now formatted nicely on the page for us to read. From here, we could save our results to the hard drive as an Excel document, PDF, or a Word document. This concludes part 4 of our STA 6000 tutorial series. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, post them in the comments, and be sure to subscribe for more product news, tutorials, and updates from Flexible Assembly.